Yes. I'm talking about MuseScore. And I'm just, I want to do a quick polling. Are there MuseScore users in the room? Whoa, is it? Oh, I didn't expect that. I thought it would be no one, actually. I thought I would be addressing developers and recruiting developers, but actually users. That's just great. OK, so this is MuseScore. It's an open source music annotation program. This is what it looks like for people who are not aware. This is sheet music, so you can create this, and then you just start playing from it. That's it. All right. Now, what is MuseScore? MuseScore is a program to write sheet music with, and above all, it's a WYSIWYG editor. So there are lots of other music notation programs out there, but this one is a true WYSIWYG, which makes it extremely simple to make sheet music with. Second, it's quite fast. In order to add your notes, you can do it via the mouse, also keyboard, and as well with MIDI. So in the latest 0.9.4 version, which was released 2 days ago, the MIDI import for Windows was being added to it. It used to be on Linux already, but now on Windows as well. And we are also seeking for developers for extending the MIDI import functionality. Then next, there's also an integrated sequencer in there. Also very good import-export of music XML as well as MIDI, of course. This needs extra work as well, but I'll come back to that later. It's also platform independent. It's written on Qt or Qt. Which means we should be able to build it for Linux, Windows, and Macintosh with ease. But the Macintosh one is right now still giving us problems because of a font issue. Another thing is it's been translated to 12 languages, which is really great. The last 6 languages has been added in just 4 or 5 months time. So it's really getting a lot of adoption right now. And then last but not least, it's GPL licensed. Now a little bit of the history. It all started in 2002 by a certain person called Werner Schwed, and he's right here on Fosden. He's sitting there, so if you want to speak with him later on, you can go ahead. He started this in 2002 as a spin-off of Muse, which is a MIDI sequencer. Now, initially it was only for Linux, and the port was only available at the end of 2007. Now also, by the end of 2007, the 0.9 release was being made, and since then it was quite stable and quite usable just for end users who were just looking for a good notation program. So by that time, we had around 50 downloads per day, which wasn't bad, knowing that there was zero marketing around it. Then, in 2008, in September, we launched the MuseScore.org website, which was quite a milestone, because at that point, we just made a step from 50 downloads per day to 200 downloads per day. And that was quite a step forward, because lots of people were coming, or newcomers, new users, and on the website, people were finding bugs and so on, and that speed up the development process. Development cycle a lot, so that was really great. And then just 2 days ago, the final version 0.9.4 was being released, and we are right now at 600 downloads per day, which is really exciting, but it should be much more normally in the future. So this is what it looked like in 2008. As you can see, we had a tipping point there at the end of September. And normally in 2009, we should be going over, let's say, 20, 30, even perhaps 40,000 downloads per month, which would be really, really great. Now, what do people say right now about MuseScore, about the current state? The top one is a teacher, Joseph Pisano. And as a teacher, he used to use Finale, more specifically Finale Notepad, which is the free version of it. It was a free version because in September, the Finale people decided to make the next release of Finale Notepad non-free. And people have to pay right now $10. Now, $10 is enough for just people who are looking for a sheet music program in order to look for an alternative. And just at that moment, MuseScore was ready for not prime time, but just for those users to accept them. And therefore, we were just at the right time. And he was really delighted when he found MuseScore. And as you can read, he will be promoting it to his students as well. Now, the second one, he was mainly looking at the quality output. And for lots of you will probably know Lilypond, which is also a score typesetter program on Linux, as well as Windows and Mac. And Lilypond users are used to the high quality output of Lilypond. Now, since MuseScore uses the same font and also some of the same basic principles of formatting the score, MuseScore looks great as well. The third one, he was looking for a program which was easy to use. And look, he used to be a Sibelius user. Sibelius is the number one music notation program on the market. And due to the easy handling of MuseScore, he moved over to Sibelius. To MuseScore, which is great. Now, we do have some development challenges. First of all, the MIDI. I talked about it at the beginning. Now, the MIDI is right now just simple import. It doesn't know anything about real-time import, so it's like you import by using your keyboard as well as you still have to put in the time and so on, so which makes it a little bit, it's usable, but it can be enhanced a lot. So if there are people here who are used to write MIDI software or whatever, just contact Ramesh, because I'm not the MIDI guy, and just get in touch with him. Now, also the playback can be improved a lot. At this moment, lots of musical data is not taken into account to play the score as it should. And then another big important thing would be extra features for guitar players. So fretboards and tap staffs can be supported as well. Of course, also some more help on the Music XML import and export. This is really important because if you want to convert users from Finale or Sibelius towards MuseScore, you have to be able to take your catalog or your sheet music collection with you as well. And therefore, Music XML input and output is really important. So the conversion of their files from Sibelius or Finale can go as smooth as possible. And Music XML right now is the standard for doing this. And then last but not least, there is also lots of talk on the mailing list going on about more fonts. So right now, MuseScore uses the Feta font, also used by Lilypond, but it's the only font available. So we are missing support for other fonts, jazz fonts and so on. There are some fonts available, mainly copyrighted fonts, which means you can only use them for personal use. They cannot be distributed. So we are looking for a font wizard here who knows how to make a jazz font or something similar. If you are that wizard or you know someone, please contact me, because jazz font is really, really much requested by many users, and that might also, again, attract users from Sibelius and Finale towards MuseScore. Now, a last thing which I added, it's not actually connected with the development challenges, is more regarding marketing or promotion. Next week, I'm going to meet 40 students who are graphic students, or how do you call it, artwork designers, and they will help MuseScore to create a set of artwork, starting with the logo and the house styling and icons within MuseScore, the splash screen and so on. Also banners for promotional purposes. And we would like to do this and while fixing or while adding the new features, and then have it ready for MuseScore 1.0. With this rebranding, we hope that MuseScore will have a quite professional look and convince new users to start using MuseScore. This rebranding effort will also be some kind of an open design project. So if you are going to MuseScore starting from within 2 weeks or something, you will see posts concerning logos and house style and so on. And it's a purpose that the community is getting involved and getting votes, for instance, for all the logo proposals. Because there will be 40 students, so there will be lots of proposals, and it will be fun to figure out with you guys what would be the nicest logo for us when we release MuseScore 1.0. Now, the top challenge right now still is the release of the Macintosh version. We have a cute issue problem with the Feta font. I talked with Werner this afternoon, and he has some idea on how to fix this. Normally, at this moment, as we see it, it's a cute problem, but we might circumvent it by just pulling out the font out of the distribution, because right now it's baked in. We might pull it out and put it on the file system as an external font, and that might just be the start of a solution for this. If you are a Qt developer yourself and you might be aware on how fonts work or whatever, you can also visit this this URL and kick in, because right now the biggest asked feature is MuseScore for Macintosh. Lots of people or musicians worldwide use Macintosh or Apple, and therefore it's one of the biggest requested features, and we will probably be waiting for the Mac release before 1.0. The reason is quite simple. If we do mailing worldwide to all music schools, then and we are missing the Macintosh version, then it's quite hard for people. Probably lots of people will just draw back and not get involved into with MuseScore. So this is our top challenge for the moment. Now, if you want to follow MuseScore, and lots of you do already, then there's the website. There's also the Twitter channel. The Twitter channel, you can follow the daily developments, if there are any, because the development group isn't that big. So it's updated every 2 days, 3 days, something like that. And it will tell you about new pre-releases on Windows and so on. So you can grab them and check it out yourself and check for the bug fixes. Then also Delicious is being used a lot by us, because we bookmark all the blogs and all the reviews we find on MuseScore. So if you are looking for, let's say, some information about MuseScore, not only can you find it on the website itself, but also on the Delicious bookmark page, where you can find all kind of bookmarks for all kind of languages, about blog posts where MuseScore is being featured in. And then of course the Facebook group or page. So connect with us, come to the website, just any problem you have, any crash you have, something else, try to define the steps as easy as possible so we can reproduce it and write a fix a fix real fast, and then release another pre-release so you can get a much more stable version of MuseScore. That's it. Yeah, go ahead.
Two questions. Number one, have you talked with anybody who is interested in Konokal, the Indian rhythmic notation language?
No.
As a way of building that into your JazzScore. If anybody here knows anything about Konokal, love to see that idea come in.
I know about GMPU, which is the Chinese numbered or ciphered music notation, but this Hindi one, or Indian one? Okay, okay.
And the second question, with respect to integration, do you have any contacts with either the Ardour community or the Blender community to bring MIDI functionality into their sequencing timeline?
That's a question for Ramesh. He's coming over from Muse, so he should be able to answer that after the talk, probably. Some other questions? Then I guess it will be over in 30 seconds. Voila.